Good morning, viewers and listeners. Today I am with Ms. Vandita Singh, founder of TIA, the Image Academy, Mumbai. Hi, Vandita, how are you doing today?
Hi, I'm good. I'm fine. Thank you. So, I believe you had a lot of questions to ask me, so I am here to answer them, and they seem to be coming in from the audience.
That's right, Vandita. So, let's just jump into it then. So, please tell me, according to you, or generally, is it more important to behave in a way that is true to yourself, or rather in a way that is socially acceptable?
And that's a nice question, actually. Whatever is true to ourselves, basically, I think may not be true for others.
That's correct.
Right?
Right.
So, there are certain unsaid rules which I feel that should be followed professionally and socially, and some of them are also written down. So, I think as long as we follow them in a social and professional environment, it's good. One tends to be true to themselves when they are in their personal environment and personal zone. So, definitely, when you go to socialize, I'm sure there is a different behavior that you don't don.
Correct. And also people tend to see that as fake probably or pretentious. What is your take on that? Do you think that having a different persona in public and having a different persona with a group of friends would be something that people would see as fake, or is that natural and necessary in today's world?
Sure, that's so between your personal, professional and social behavior, if there is a marginal difference, that is acceptable.
Okay.
But if it is a totally different personality in your personal life and in your professional life and in your social life, mm-hmm. and there is absolutely no link, and I don't know who Anushka is.
Okay.
When I see her personally, when I see her professionally, and when I see her socially, then I think that is quite questionable. And each one of us do tend to put on a different behavior when we are in front of others, or when we walk into our offices, or when we go for social get-togethers. Even in social get-togethers, I think our behavior is different when we go for dinner, or when we are going out partying with our friends,
okay.
or we are going out for a Goa trip or something like that.
So, being true to yourself, how important do you think just that part of the statement is? How important is it to be true to oneself?
I think that is very important, because being a counseling psychologist and an image consultant, I do a lot of grooming, mm-hmm. inner grooming, whereby I link their inner true self to what they want to be outside, when I groom them from outside. Because no matter how much I groom them from outside, but if they are not wearing a dress,
correct.
Or they are not wearing the kind of makeup that also reflects from within, which makes them comfortable, they will fail to have that impact in the outside world.
Correct.
So I totally agree with you.
Correct. So, in terms of what is socially acceptable nowadays in India, how do you think things have progressed in terms of just behavior?
Mm-hmm.
Like ranging from maybe women not drinking alcohol in public as much,
mm-hmm.
but now that's socially acceptable. What is your take on that? What do you think? Like, do you think India is progressing, or do you think it's just pertaining to the younger generation?
I think in my view, there are a lot of behaviors which have become socially acceptable now. When you're talking about drinking of, women drinking in public, yes, sure. As much as a guy enjoys a drink, I'm sure women also
exactly
like to have
correct.
Their
correct.
Swigs. So I think that is totally acceptable. And there are a lot of other things also whereby, I do see a lot of men and women mingling around together, and a lot of women also objecting to, the men's group going on one side and
right.
walking, and a woman's group going on one side and talking. Nowadays, I see a lot of men and women mingling together. So that is also a behavioral change. In terms of communication, I think, women have become more vociferous and vocal. The men still tend to be quiet. And I have seen a lot of changes in terms of social behavior. And I still see that there is a lot of changes in people accepting themselves as they are. And I think that is where the true behavior comes in.
That's right.
So basically you need to ask me is image consulting a big part of dealing with true nature, or is it telling you that you have to train and learn only the socially acceptable behavior? At least in TI, the Image Academy, we don't do that. As a psychologist, I try to understand your lifestyle or your experiences, and these are the things which actually make your behavior. And if I do think that there is some correctional behavior that needs to come into focus, then I do that as well. And that is how we go about it. And then we groom you from outside, and that is how you get the link.